Hey guys, this is David Kwon, and welcome to an Hour of Kwonmunism. This is my third time doing something like this, and third time I'm kind of changing things up a bit. You'll notice that this video is not an hour long like a usual Hour of Kwonmunism. I've been thinking about this for a bit, and I know there's a couple of things I said that I'll do that this will happen like every weekday, like 5 days a week or 4 days a week or something like that. Yeah, that was a ridiculous claim or ridiculous promise because there's no way I'm doing that. Or I just don't have... Maybe someday I will, but not happening this time soon. I guess I set a goal that is a little too high. I shot for like, not the moon, but for like the sun there. That's what it feels like. recording myself in front of a video talking for an hour, 5 days a week. Whew. That's a lot to do, honestly. So definitely can't promise you, and I failed in that promise, as you can see. Definitely can't do every day of the week or every weekday. And this whole, I really like the idea of just talking for an hour about different topics to fill up that hour. It's particularly contemporary topics, things that are happening in the world, in America, in the industry, and in my life. Right now, in the time of the recording of the video, to kind of keep things up to date and things of that nature, and talk about my ideas or to just pretty much blabber out my thoughts, and keep it current. That's the idea behind it. I liked it. I like that concept a lot. I think doing that will help me grow, help me become a better speaker in doing this, help me become more thoughtful, and just overall just become a better tool for me to grow as a stronger, as a more knowledgeable, as a more eloquent, I guess, person. So that was like the reasoning behind why I wanted to do this Hour of Kwonmunism. But I'm gonna keep doing that. But I guess to have one video be an hour long is kind of too much, because I do want, you know, because this is a public YouTube, I guess. It is nice when people view my things and see me talk and, you know, hear my thoughts on things and then respond and then kind of, you know, give me their feedback. I like that, even if it's negative, even if it's, especially if they disagree with me. I want feedback. I think one of the things I really like doing on YouTube, and I shouldn't, is just I get into like YouTube debates. And YouTube debates are pretty ridiculous because of, like, I'm a very wordy guy. When I write things, you have no idea. When I share emails with my best friends, my emails are ridiculously long. And so is his. But mine are longer, I think. There's been times when I emailed him something and then I copied that and pasted onto a Word document to see how long it was. It was like 4 or 5 pages or something like that. It's pretty ridiculous. I'm a very wordy guy. Conciseness, I don't think is in my nature. I'm trying to be as concise as possible when I write, especially I've had to kind of force myself to do that in college when I was taking this philosophy course and when I was taking this writing course. What was hard for me was not like when the professor was just like, here's your writing assignment, and the limit is it has to be at least, you know, 5 pages long. I'm just like, okay, that's not a problem. And it can't be more than 8 pages. I'm just like, shit, can't be more than 8 pages. All right, can't be more than 8 pages. Because, seriously, I tend to write a lot. So, it's really frustrating for me when I get into debates on any YouTube channel and I'm using the comments tools to debate on YouTube, or not debate, but just have a discussion sometimes, because of the 500 character limit. And I can't post links. Like, if I'm having a similar discussion on Twitter, I could just say, alright, well, this is what I say in this link. Like, I would go to TweetLonger, or you know, that's one of the tools I can use, where I would blog about it and just post a link. Boom! You know, and have a discussion that way, or just post multiple, I don't know, threads like that. YouTube, 500 character limit, I can't post links, it's frustrating. And then the way one of the most example is on one of my recent videos, which I think I titled it, Why Shouldn't Polygamy Be Legalized? And that's where I pretty much just share my thoughts on why I think polygamy should not be legalized in the United States. And then a person comes in, a YouTube user commented on that, and this person is, I can't remember his name, it's spelled A-L-Z-U-S-K-Y, something like that. I visited the person's channel. I think the person is a female person. I'm not sure, but I'll just say it's a she. Because I remember her saying my boyfriend or something. Person could be gay, I don't know, maybe it's a guy who has a boyfriend. Anyway, he or she, I will just say she for convenience, I could be wrong. I went to her channel, and she is for pretty much all alternate forms of marriage. She even commented on one of my other videos saying, look, I'm for legalizing not only gay marriage, but also for incest, polygamy, and bestiality. And her channel is primarily focused on bestiality, seems like. Very interesting perspective to have. I personally disagree with all of that, but that's why we had this amazing discussion. But it was kind of frustrating with the YouTube setup, you know, not only because am I limited in the character, so what I ended up doing is I pretty much just write comments out in a separate thing, Imajingi, a separate app. On my MacBook, it's called the Stickies app, whatever. And then I break it into parts so that I make sure it fits into the 500 character limit. I reply my first reply, and then I reply to myself in the next comment, and I reply to that to have it be a continuous thread. That's the one way I've been able to overcome the limit. But man, but this person, of course, also responds with long points, but it's been really hard to kind of just get the sense of what's being said, although I get it, takes me a little time. She responds to one of my comments, and then she responds to that comment again with the number saying 2, 3, 4. It's like, oh my gosh, if YouTube comment wasn't... I understand why YouTube comment is limited to make streaming and all that BS, because there's so much content being uploaded to YouTube every second. To have a really full-featured comment tool would really, I think, hamper maybe the network rule. I don't know what. I'm not an expert on how the internet works. But anyway, so just saying that it's... How did I get to talking about this? This is insane. This is why I'm doing this, talking for an hour, just because it... Anyway, my point is, My point is, I like to have these kinds of discussions. I really enjoy the feedback. And I can't really have this kind of feedback on one specific topic, except I have this one gigantic-ass video that's an hour long, talking about multiple topics. First of all, most people who, you know, they're going to see that hour length, and I'm saying they're going to be intimidated by the length. And I'm probably not even gonna click on it to see it. And my videos in general don't get views anyway. So I'm alienating like a lot of people who already don't watch my videos, which is fine. I don't do this for views or anything. But I do like discussions. So in order to funnel more deeper discussions, I feel like okay, maybe just posting the entire hour of things is a bit too much. It's good for me, but is it good for viewership? And this is when I'm now starting to finally consider viewership. And which is really ironic because I know this video at most is probably gonna get, my estimate is 12 views or so. That's my estimate. I'm always amazed when my video gets more than like 30 views. That's pretty amazing to me, that a person who's not very good at blogging or vlogging, who also makes a lot of stuttering, says us a lot, says you know a lot, and does a lot, and just not at all a good speaker, doesn't edit his videos. I don't edit my videos because I'm lazy, so I don't do the fancy, like, I say one thing and I skip to the next part where I like that technique, where there are a lot of YouTube vloggers do that. I think it's a very effective technique to shorten down the length of the video, and to get the points across. And it cuts out the uhs and the unnecessary stuff that you don't want to hear. I like that. But I don't do that because I'm lazy. And like I said in another video, if this was something that was really generated enough revenue for me to live off of, I would give a lot of attention and care into my YouTube videos, which is a cycle. Because people who have an amazing following usually on YouTube, I really think generally, overall, it's because they produce great content. And they produce it in a way that, you know, that shows that they put a lot of effort and care into it. True, there are some videos who, you know, there are some channels where it's just regurgitation of whoever else is doing or just whatever. But generally, the people who I really like being subscribed to and people like, I guess this is one of the examples I give, Angry Joe Reviews. I don't know the channel name, but Angry Joe Video Game Reviews. Like, whenever I watch any of his 20-minute or 30-minute, like, videos, it's really obvious to me, like, wow, he put, like, a lot of editing and care and detail and just a lot of effort into these videos. Maybe not only him, but he also has a team, I assume, because a lot of really great, you know, when YouTube channels get big, it's no longer just one person, just one person producing content anymore. Now it's a team of people because it makes money. So it's a cycle. You can only make money, you know, you make money on YouTube by doing a lot of putting a lot of effort and sweat and love into it. And that comes back. And so it's a continuous thing. Unfortunately, I feel like some of the viewership has kind of dropped overall on YouTube, it feels like. Looking at some of the views on videos that I'm subscribed to, which is kind of unfortunate. But at the same time, people who generally do well on YouTube generally still do well because they produce great content. Me, I honestly will tell you, I do not really produce great content. It's just me in front of a video or behind my MacBook just talking about random stuff for an hour in a shirt wearing a tie. But, you know, that's me. So that's why I'm, like, really amazed when I'm like, oh my gosh, this video has 70 views. And it has, like, you know, I don't really care about likes. I don't really know what likes does. Honestly, that's actually a question. What do likes do? Why do people who are, you know, who have a big following, usually they end their videos or they start their videos, it's like, click that like button. It helps me get more views. How does that work? Why does it help them get more views? I don't understand that at all. Does it, that's something that I don't understand. Maybe I should find out more on somehow. Like, maybe that's a question I should type on. Like, dear YouTube, why is the like button important and whatnot? I don't know. I honestly never cared about the like button. I actually like, you know, I do like that, like, the viewer is participating. I do click the like button a lot when I watch videos myself, because if I like it, I like it. And then it gets recorded. For me, the like button is because I can go back to the video, because I can go back to my activity history, and it's like, hey, this is the video that you like, and I can rewatch it, or continue watching from where I left off, because sometimes I don't watch the full thing, and I'm like, I'm going to come back to this and finish it later. So that like button serves that purpose for me. But, you know, that's not to say, like, I see the purpose in dislike button too. And this is something else I'm going to talk about in another video, like the danger of downvoting and dislikes, whatever. But I like dislikes, because when I look at sometimes I look at my video stats, I'm just like, oh, I have this many dislikes on this video. It doesn't make me upset. It doesn't make me like, oh, somebody hated my video. Like, it's not like that. I'm just like, okay, so these people disagree with me on this thing or didn't like this video. I like that. I like to learn those things because, like I said, I have a personality where I like to have discussions and I like to have debates and I like being honest and just, you know, just having that. I don't really get flustered or bothered by having debates or anything. I like that. That is, you know, that's one of the reasons why I love the fact that, like, I don't know. I like that. I like having interesting debates, people with opposite viewpoints at me coming out and saying, you're totally wrong because blah, 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 blah. I'm like, cool, okay, let's have that discussion. The only problem I have is when that you're wrong because you suck. You know what I mean? Like, points that make the reason behind a person not liking my viewpoints or disagreeing with me, when it's, okay, I'm going to be blunt, when it's stupid, then, like, it's a waste of time. I don't respond. I'm like, you think I'm stupid? Okay, case closed. I can't really say anything to that. But when it's like, I think you're stupid because this, look at, like, because there's this book out here, maybe not this book, but if you think about it this way, it's this way. I'm just like, oh, well, you make a good point. Let me respond to that because I think, you know, when we have the discussion, that's what I love. I don't really care if you disagree with me or not, as long as we have an amazing discussion. Long story short, because this is a very long story right now, it's fucking 16 minutes. Long story short, in order for me to really foster great discussion, I feel like I need to talk, have a video on one topic at a time, even if the fact of the matter is, it's me talking in front of the camera for 1 hour straight. I'm still going to have it broken up. So this is Hour of Kwonmunism, number 3 actually. This is my third time doing this ever. And I feel like I'm getting worse as I go. Jeez. I feel like my Hour of Kwonmunism number 1 was the best I've ever done on this. Hopefully that's not the case as I do more of this, but my goal with this is to do an hour, one of these, at least once every week. That's the goal, at least once every week. I'm not shooting for the sun or the moon anymore. I'm keeping my goals realistic. And have it be close to an hour, have it approximately be talk about 5 topics or so, and each different topics have a category, like U.S. news story or American story, world news story, and then the third topic would be something about video games or movies or entertainment industry, and then just a topic that is kind of just a random topic. It can actually be a topic that you guys want me to talk about. So it could be a user-generated thing. I already, actually, in this Hour of Kwonmunism, one of my topics will be something like that. When some person commented on one of my videos, and he was like, how about you talk about this topic? And I was like, that's a great topic, actually. Yeah, I'll definitely do that. So that'd be the fourth topic. Fifth topic may not happen, would be like a book I read. Definitely not happening in this Hour of Kwonmunism, but that could be one. And then the sixth, I will always end my Hour of Kwonmunism with something personal. A personal story, personal experience, just something from my life that I will end this video with. So that will be my format, that will be my goal. In this Hour of Kwonmunism, which is happening on, it's technically April 17th, but it's midnight right now. So it will be, April 17th. So the topics for today, so starting the next videos, will be the first topic. It's a U.S. news story. It's going to be about patenting of a human gene. And then the second story will be about banks around the world and how now there's kind of the whole concept of too big to fail happening around the world with banks. And topic number 3, actually, I forgot what I was going to talk about in terms of gaming news. I'll come back to you guys with that. Well, you'll see my third video on a gaming topic. Oh, I remember now. Shoot, the third topic would be about Nintendo, actually. And there was this Michael Pachter's video on the Pack Attack, where he talked about the fact that, you know, Nintendo staying as a hardware business is kind of dumb, in business sense. And I want to talk about that. So that's my third topic. Fourth topic is something that a YouTube user commented on one of my videos and asked me to talk about, which is talking about charity, domestic charity, like nonprofit. Domestic meaning because I'm American, it would be doing nonprofit work in America versus doing nonprofit work overseas, and just talking about like that, compare and contrast that. So that's my fourth topic, and the final topic I will be talking about today for Hour of Kwonmunism number 3 is just recently I've been having these weird dreams. And I'm going to talk about that. Just some of the dreams I've been having and my thoughts on that. So that's how our communism number 3 will happen. Definitely click on the next videos in this playlist. And yeah.